this cornerstone, this solid ground, forms through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, what striving seeks, my comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand.
In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe, this gift of love and righteousness.
His body lay, light of the world by darkness slain, then bursting forth in glorious day, up from the grave he rose again, and as he stands in victory, since God has lost its grip on me.
No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hands till he returns and calls me home, hearing the power of Christ, hearing the death of Christ, hearing the resurrection of Christ, I live. The scripture says that in him I live, in him I move, in him I have my being. Christ in me, the hope of glory. Somebody lift up your hands and thank God for waking you up this beautiful day. Elerusi braka bobosia. My God, we give you praise. My God, we honor you. My God, we magnify your name. Thank you, Lord God Almighty, for another beautiful day that you have made. The one thing that I've come to conclude is that every day is a beautiful day because you are the one that makes them. And I give you all the praise. I give you all the glory. I give you all the honor. I adore you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, precious Lord. Thank you for waking us up. Thank you for a beautiful day. Oh, Lord God of glory, We thank you. We bless your name. Be thou exalted. In the mighty name of Jesus, we have prayed. Good morning, Father. Good morning, Lord Jesus Christ. Good morning, precious Holy Spirit of grace. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to this broadcast. We continue in our series, The Power of What You Know. And I'll be looking at the scriptures again. And looking at Ephesians chapter 1. Ephesians chapter 1, for the sake of time, you already know the scriptures, but I'll just read verses 17 and verse 17 to verse 20. It says that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him, the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that ye may know what is the hope of his calling, and what the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, and what is the exceeding greatness of his power toward us who believe, according to the working of his mighty power, which he wrought in Christ when he raised him from the dead and set him at his own right hand in the heavenly places, far above principalities and powers and might and dominion and every name that is named, not only in this world but in that which is to come. Let me look at Ephesians chapter 1 verse 18 and verse 19. It says, the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of his calling, and what the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, and what is the exceeding greatness of his power. What is the exceeding greatness of his power to us word who believe, according to the working of his mighty power. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, looking at the power of what you know, and I just want to recap to just quickly tell you that we began to say that we must build capacity in certain areas for us to have knowledge. We must build capacity in certain areas for us to have knowledge. The first capacity you must build is capacity to look and see. I'm dealing with the letter L. So to look, you see from looking. Praise the name of the Lord. You build capacity. That's the first one. The second one is to build capacity to listen. To listen. You listen to hear. You listen to hear. Hallelujah. You build capacity to listen. And yesterday we looked at building capacity to learn. You learn to know and understand. You learn to know and understand. Hallelujah. You learn to know and understand. Today we are going to be looking at building capacity to leverage. Building capacity to leverage. And so I'm going to read again to you Ephesians chapter 1 verse 18. The eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that ye may know what is the hope of his calling, and what the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, and what is the exceeding greatness of his power to us who believe, according to the working of his mighty power. Hallelujah. Leverage. What is leverage? Leverage is a simple device for lifting or moving heavy loads. A lever is a simple device for lifting or moving heavy load, because the word leverage comes from the word lever. A lever. Hallelujah. That's where the word comes from. Now, so anything that can be used to move, to gain advantage. Anything that can be used to gain advantage is a lever. So the word leverage is a mechanical power or advantage gained through using a lever. So my simple definition of the word leverage is the word power and advantage. Leverage simply means using your advantage. Hallelujah. Making use of your advantage. And we are going to look at the scriptures, and we are going to see a couple of scriptures that that speaks to making use of your advantage. Let me go ahead and tell you how this relates to knowledge. There are people who have gone ahead of you. There are people who know things that you do not know, that you need to learn from. And you take their advantage of knowing them to know what they know that you don't know. You take advantage of reading your Bible to understand, to know. The Bible is enough capacity for you to leverage on. So you read people's books, you read people's you read commentaries, you read things to know. You take advantage of the opportunities. And I will show you in the scriptures. Hallelujah. Leverage on your social capital. Hallelujah. The truth of the matter is that, now, let me quickly say this before I even move on. Build social capital. There are two kinds of social capital. As I sat down to think yesterday, in my opinion, and this is my view, there are two types of social capital. There is the informal social capital and there is the formal social capital. The formal social capital talks about your workspace, your business space, and all of that. Your informal social capital talks about your friends and all the relationships that you have built. Now, you must take advantage of the people that in your formal social capital, you must take advantage of the people that are ahead of you. That are ahead of you to learn what they know. Hallelujah. To learn what they know so that you can know what they know that you don't know. The truth of the matter is learning comes by either questions or by observations. So you either ask questions or you sit down to observe. You know, you learn by observations or you ask questions. Hallelujah. All right. So in your informal sector, your informal social capital, you can sit down just from gisting and from communication, you will learn a lot of things. So leverage on your friends, leverage on your bosses, leverage on your subordinates at work. Leverage on what they know. It's not only your bosses that know things you don't know. Even your subordinates know the things that you don't know. There are lots of things that they know that you don't know. Praise the name of the Lord. So leverage is that power or advantage that is gained. So you gain power, you gain advantage from others. Now let's look at the scriptures. In 1 Samuel 19. 1 Samuel 19. And I want you to quickly turn to the book of 1 Samuel chapter 19. Time will fail me to actually read everything that I want to read to you in 1 Samuel 19. But the truth of the matter is, I will tell you the story so that you can read it on your own and you can gain a lot that you need to gain from it. Now, when Saul wanted to kill David, and he sent them to go and look for David in the wife or in the house of Michal, in his house with Michal, his wife. When Michal got to know, Michal told David, "You have to escape," and sent David away. And now, so they told Saul that David was in Ramah. And Saul started sending his army to go and look for David. Now, this is what David did. When David came to Ramah, David didn't just start running. David went to Samuel. Now, let me leverage on the man that knows what I don't know. I don't know how I came about being anointed king, but there is a man that had the knowledge. Let me leverage on him. Let me go. So he didn't run to anybody. He ran to him to Samuel in Ramah. And the Bible says that Samuel brought him into the company. Now, Samuel knew what David didn't know. So he brought him into the company. When he brought him into the company, the Bible says that when the army that came to take him came into the company, they began to speak in tongues, the same language. They began to prophesy the same language that Samuel and the company and David used, that they used to speak. Now, watch this. David didn't know that language could make him win until he came back to Samuel. When he joined the company and they began to prophesy, the army that came joined him in prophesying. When you read it to the end, you will see that Saul himself came and was also defeated by that same thing that David didn't know until he came to the point of meeting Samuel. When you leverage on people who know what you don't know, you will know what they know and even much more. Build capacity to leverage. Now, for you to build capacity to leverage, your character must be good. Your character must be good. Every relationship is serviced. Your character, what kind of character do you have? Are you a friendly person, as a matter of fact? I'm not talking about the looks on your face. In your heart, are you a friendly person? Do you have ability to relate with people? Build capacity to leverage. Now, there's something that I want you to understand about leverage and about social capital. Don't wait until you have need to begin to look for people. There are people who have, they are worse in this area. They don't check on people. They don't do anything. They don't ask this. After 1 month, once they have a need, they remember you. Oh, the Lord led me to call you. I'm sorry. That's not the way to leverage on people. Do you keep your relationships well? Character is important. Can you be trusted? Character is important. Don't go. It's only when you have need. 2 months, 3 months. You don't say hello. You don't even send a message. Then suddenly you are in a tight corner. Oh, who can I go to? Then you remember. That's bad. Hallelujah. Build capacity to leverage. Build your character. Every relationship is serviced. Learn to keep. You know, I heard something yesterday. And somebody said, when we get to that bridge, we will cross it. And I just jokingly said, what if you don't even get to the bridge? How will you cross? So it is not about the bridge. It's about relationship. Because the person on the other side can know a shorter road for you to take than going through the bridge. Hallelujah. Listen to me. Learn to build your character. Then you can leverage. Now, don't be an opportunistic person. Leveraging does not require being opportunistic or having a kind of, an ill motive for wanting to leverage. Let me learn what they know so that I can take over their space. You never go far. You never go far. Leverage with the right motives in mind. So build character. Have the right motives. Have the right motives. What's the reason for wanting to know what they know that you don't know? Check yourself. Bible says that David was when he said, Lord, try me and check my reins to see that I am okay. Evaluate the reasons why you want to know what you want to know. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Leverage. David leveraged on Samuel. I'll give you one last scripture on leverage. Time is so short. But I'll give you one last scripture on leverage. You know? Or I'll give you some scriptures quickly so that you can read them on your own. 1 Samuel chapter 20, verse 5 to 23. Read it. David leveraged on his relationship with Jonathan. David leveraged on his relationship with Jonathan to be able to. Saul wanted to kill him, but David leveraged on his relationship with Jonathan. And Jonathan showed him. He said, if I shoot the arrow and I say, go and pick it from beyond that place, it means that you don't come back. Hallelujah. Leverage. Ruth leveraged on Naomi in spite of the fact that everything went bad. Now, this is one thing I want to leave with you. Listen to me, people of God. Do not look at people's condition to think that you can't leverage on them. Naomi had lost everything, but Ruth saw something that was deep. It wasn't about material things at all. Some people leverage because they feel that somebody is rich. So that's why they think. They think that it, seeing the material things means that they can know the success story. No. There are successful people who got their wealth in bad ways. That's not it. Don't look at the material things. Naomi, Ruth did not look at the material. It says that, look, where you go, I will go. No matter what, even if there's no child in you anymore, it doesn't matter. And you know the story. Let me give you this last one. Mark chapter 9. Mark chapter 9. Mark chapter 9. Jesus came down. You can read it in the Living Message translation. It will be clear to you. Jesus was passing and he saw his disciples arguing with a man. And the man said, what are you arguing about? And they said, the man said, I brought my sons to your disciples and they could not cast out the demon that was in him. And Jesus said to them in verse 19, he says, what tiny faith you have. How much longer must I be with you until you believe? How much longer must I be patient with you? Bring the boy. Now, what was he saying? He said, you're not learning anything. You're not leveraging on being around me, being with me. You're not learning. You're not observing me and all of that. And of course, they brought the boy. Jesus asked, do you believe? And all the rest of the story. And the boy was healed. And then the disciples said, look, this is our time. Let's learn. Let's leverage on this action. Why were we not able to cast out this? And Jesus said, you know what? There's a new thing I want to teach you so you can know. This type goeth not out. They learnt it. They leveraged on the actions of Jesus at that particular moment to be able to learn something new. Leverage. Take advantage of the opportunities you have to become better. That is what leverage simply is. Taking advantage of the opportunities you have to become better. I believe that God will make you better this season. Amen. Leverage on this season to get into the secret place of the Most High. You know, in your busy schedule, you have not been able to get into the secret place. 6 a.m. you are up, you are at work. You are back in the evening at 7 or thereabout, you are tired. You sleep, you wake up, but here you are in the confines and comfort of your home. Take advantage of this season. I told you that these 14 days is critical. It's critical to your development. You will develop new things. Leverage on this moment and the Lord will do you good. Let's lift up our voices and begin to pray. And begin to pray. Father, we give you praise. Father, we honor you. We adore you. Thank you for what you have done. We bless your name, O God. May your name alone be glorified. In the mighty name of Jesus, as your children take advantage of the opportunities they have, Lord, open up to them. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, precious Lord. Thank you, Lord. We will become better. We will become greater. We will increase on every side. In the mighty name of Jesus, your name will be glorified. For Christ in us, the hope of glory, that we may know what is the hope of his calling, what the riches of his inheritance in his saints are, and the exceeding greatness of his power toward us who believe, which he wrought by the working of his mighty power in Christ. Thank you, Father. We are bigger, better, we are stronger, and we will be settled. In Jesus' name. Till I see you tomorrow, the Lord bless you mightily. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.